thought it might be you. What is it, Miles?
I had to see you.
I came here to get away from you.
I couldn't eat or sleep, think, do anything until I saw you. Until I told you how incredibly sorry I am for what happened last night.
It wasn't something that happened, Miles. It was something you did against my will, over my objections, in complete disregard for me or my feelings.
You can't say anything to me that I haven't already told myself. I behave like an animal.
I don't want to talk about it.
You have to talk about it. I love you, Fallon. Can't you see what I did was because I love you?
Let go of me. What happens next? Are you going to rape me again?
All I want is to be close again.
We both have to want it, Miles, for it to mean anything.
I can't defend what I did, but I didn't mean to hurt you. I know I have to change. I want to, so I will. Believe me, baby, there isn't anything I wouldn't do for you. Anything.
You can't just take me, Miles. As if I were a possession or a thing.
Mr. Carrington?
Miles, I don't know what's gone on between you and Fallon, but I'll put it very simply. I don't want my daughter hurt.
I know what Fallon means to you. Believe me, she's every bit as precious to me.
Good. Because if I ever hear that you've so much as harmed a hair on her head, there won't be words enough to express how sorry you'll be.
Fallon changed my life, sir. I love her. All I want to do is make her happy. I mean every word of it. I'm going back to California tonight. I'm not going to press you. I just wanted you to hear what I had to say before you make up your mind. Between me and Jeff. Goodbye, sir.
Why can't it be easier? I don't know what to do.
Well, darling, you'll find the answer. Just listen to your heart.